Hello students, I am Dr. Madhumati, Deputy Coordinator of the Early Childhood Education and Administration Department at Srimati VHT Central Institute of Home Science, Bangalore. Today I am going to teach you about Rational Emotive Therapy. Let me give you a short introduction on what Rational Emotive Therapy or Rational Emotive Behavior Therapy is. It is a form of therapeutic psychology that has emerged from behaviorism. Rational emotive behavior therapy is one of the cognitive behavioral approaches to counseling and psychotherapy that was established in the mid-1950s by a person called as Albert Ellis. Ellis lived between 1913 and 2007, and he derived REBT theory mainly from the ancient Asian philosophers like Gautama Buddha, Lao Tzu, and Confucius. He also took inspiration from the Greeks, Romans, Aurelius, and Epicurus, and others. He also derived REBT from several modern constructivist philosophers like Kant, Russell, and Dewey. REBT is a therapy that consciously uses cognitive, emotive, and behavioral techniques to help clients. These theorists stress that human beings have choices. The control of ideas, attitudes, feelings, and actions is specific to the person who arranges a life according to personal dictates. Having little control of what happens or what actually exists, people do have choices and control over how they view the world and how they react to difficulties. The goal of REBT is to replace irrational beliefs, which are rigid, inconsistent with reality, and also illogical, with a new set of rational beliefs, which are flexible and non-extreme. As Ellis has stated, irrational beliefs have the following characteristics: rigid and extreme, inconsistent with reality, illogical or nonsensical, proneness to produce dysfunctional feelings, proneness to lead dysfunctional behavioral consequences, demanding, awful zing and terribilizing, depreciating human worth, and so on. Rational beliefs which help the client live longer and happier are developed through REBT. Since REBT is a form of tolerance training, three of the most important approaches to achieve tolerance are unconditional self-acceptance, unconditional other acceptance, and unconditional life acceptance. In general, REBT is an approach which is problem-focused, goal-directed, structured, and logical in its practice, educational-focused, primarily present-centered, and future-oriented, and skills are emphasized and having largely active and directive therapist. This means that in this approach, the therapist points out to the client that he or she has irrational beliefs and tries to help the client to discontinue the cycle of irrational beliefs. The goal is setting new beliefs which are rational, being active and directive. The therapist challenges the client's irrational beliefs by using cognitive, affective, and behavioral techniques. The learning objectives of this module are to understand the key concepts of rational emotive behavioral therapy, to learn the techniques of rational emotive behavioral therapy. Let us now study the biological basis of REBT. According to Ellis, REBT suggests a biological tendency for human behavior. He says people have a biological tendency to think irrationally and dysfunctionally. Also, from his point of view, people have the power to work towards changing their dysfunctional thinking and behavior by the application of cognitive, emotive, and behavioral methods. Ellis also points out a social basis, where social interest has a rational concept. Most people choose to live and enjoy themselves in a social group or community. If they do not act normally, protect the rights of others, and abet social survival, it is unlikely that they will create the kind of world in which they themselves live comfortably and happily. Nevertheless, although it is preferable to be valued by others, we do not have to think that we must be valued by others and become a prisoner of their approval. He states a psychological basis also, where he believes that healthy people have an internal locus of control. I'm sure all of you would have heard of locus of control. It is what makes human beings disturbed, and they concentrate on external events as the source of their disturbances. In reality, people's negative interpretation of events leads to problems and makes them unhappy. In fact, human beings, by their present thoughts, feelings, and actions, maintain their self-disturbing. People's thoughts, feelings, and behaviors strongly include and interact with each other. This can be explained through the ABCDE theory. Let me tell you what ABCDE theory means. For a rational explanation of personality, Ellis introduced the ABCDE theory. At point A are activating events. At point B are beliefs. These beliefs lead to emotional, behavioral, and cognitive consequences. Rational beliefs lead to people to functional consequences, and irrational beliefs lead them to dysfunctional consequences. At point D are disputing the client's irrational beliefs. This process leads to E, which is efficient rational beliefs. In general, the main aim of REBT is to change dysfunctional feelings and maladaptive behaviors into functional feelings and adaptive behaviors. This is done by changing the core rigid thinking, that is demandingness, and its derivatives, for example, catastrophizing, awfulization, frustration intolerance, and global evaluation, into flexible thinking and acceptance attitude. Let us see how Albert Ellis viewed the human nature. According to Ellis, the philosophers found that human beings who are natural constructivists largely disturb themselves about adversities because they choose to add to these adversities their own irrational beliefs. Ellis added to this that the nature of people is such that when they think, they also feel and behave. When they feel, they also think and behave. And when they behave, they also think and feel. Their thoughts, feelings, and behaviors strongly include and interact with each other. The central theory of REBT says that people largely disturb themselves by thinking in terms of absolute imperatives, that is, shoulds, oughts, and musts. Therefore, thinking in terms of absolute imperatives is the reason of disturbance and maladaptive behavior in human beings. Now, let us examine a few key concepts of the REBT therapy. The REBT therapy focuses on present events and the person's reaction to those events. According to REBT, people have almost complete responsibility for their ideas and for their feelings. The role of the counselor is to attack the false beliefs that cause negative reactions to events. It is better for people to focus on negating specific behaviors than to develop a negative self-image. The A, B, C, D, and E approach shows how problems develop and how to treat them. Effective strategies with children include direct teaching of concepts, such as teaching the child to like oneself, to not take things too seriously, to realize that there is joy in participation, to realize that achievement requires effort, or to realize that one does not have to be perfect. Now let us see the counseling process. The aim of REBT is to help clients an intensive, profoundly philosophical and emotional change. Therefore, it helps clients to see and change their irrational beliefs and set new beliefs which are rational. REBT sees thinking, feeling and behaving as an integrated process. Therefore, a large number of cognitive, emotive, and behavioral methods are used in this therapeutic approach. Ellis emphasized the importance of his therapeutic approach and that REBT seems to be more comprehensive than most other behavior therapies in that it strives for its clients getting better and not merely feeling better. REBT counselors would often use cognitive, emotive, and behavioral techniques with their clients. These various techniques would maximally help clients overcome their anxieties. According to Ellis, some cognitive, emotive, and behavioral techniques that REBT counselors might use in counseling are as follows. The cognitive techniques deal with clients' cognitions. Counselors, by using these techniques, help clients to change their beliefs. Some of the cognitive techniques are as follows. The first one is disputing irrational believing and emoting behaving. Let us examine how this works. At first, counselors might show clients their irrational beliefs by asking questions such as, where is the evidence for your belief? Why is this so terrible? These kinds of questions raise the consciousness in clients and help them to begin thinking on a more rational level. Clients can be asked, for example, where is the evidence that I should not have any problem in any life? Typical answer would be, there is no evidence that I should not have any problems in my life. Gradually, clients are able to see that things are not as bad as they make them out to be. Clients would be taught to do logical disputing of their irrational beliefs. The second one is rational coping self-statement. Clients here repeat rational coping self-statements such as, I am never a failure or a loser, but just an imperfect human who fails sometimes. The third one is positive visualization. In this technique, the counselors help clients in reaching their achievement, confidence, or self-efficacy. The fourth technique is called as modeling, where counselors help clients to see that other people have similar problems. Moreover, clients can also model themselves after those people. Fifth one is psychoeducational methods. Clients can be encouraged to read self-help materials related to rational emotive behavior therapy. The sixth technique is cognitive distraction. By using cognitive distractions such as reading, watching TV, meditation and yoga, clients temporarily block out some of their anxieties. The seventh technique is practical problem-solving techniques, where counselors can help their clients to use more practical methods of tackling their problems, such as assertiveness training, social skills training, and decision-making. There are emotional techniques also which are used in REBT. The emotional techniques help clients to imagine themselves in different situations. According to Ellis, some of the techniques are as follows. The first one is unconditional self-acceptance. The counselor makes the client familiar with the ways in which he or she could accept himself or herself unconditionally as a person. The second one is unconditional other acceptance, wherein at first the counselors would give their clients other acceptance and that they are accepted. Then they will help them to see how others can be accepted as worthwhile human beings. The third one is shame attacking exercises. In order to achieve unconditional self-acceptance, counselors help clients to remove their guilt and self-blaming. The fourth one is rational emotive imagery. By this technique, clients could be shown how to imagine some terrible things happening. This technique helps clients to train themselves to feel healthy disappointment instead of unhealthy anxiety. The fifth one is strong rational coping statements. These kinds of statements help clients undo their anxious reactions. For example, I'm not a miracle maker and can only do my best. The last one is humor. Since anxious clients take things too seriously, therapists might encourage clients to use their sense of humor. There are some behavioral techniques as well in REBT. By using these behavioral techniques, clients are encouraged to do some activities that help them to overcome their anxieties. According to Ellis, some of the behavioral techniques are as follows. The first one being reinforcement. Clients might be encouraged to reward themselves with some pleasurable activities only after they did some risks they commonly avoided. The second one is penalization. If clients refuse to change their thinking, feeling, and behaving, then they might be encouraged to take some real penalties to discourage their resistance. For example, doing some very unpleasant tasks. The last one is skill training. The counselors might work with their clients' assertiveness. They also might encourage them to use assertiveness training workshops. Now for the actual therapy process. REBT has emerged from what Albert Ellis considered a limited rational persuasive therapy into a therapy that consciously uses cognitive, emotive, and behavioral techniques to help clients. Ellis considers himself a philosophical or educational therapist who uses a didactic, cognition-oriented, explicative approach to change. Founded on the idea that what distresses people is not the event but their judgment of the event, REBT theorists stress that human beings have choices about their thoughts. The control of ideas, attitudes, feelings, and actions is specific to the person who arranges a life according to personal dictates. Having little control over what happens or what actually exists, people do have both choices and controls over how they view the world and react to difficulties. Ellis viewed humans as naturally irrational, self-defeating individuals who need to be taught to change crooked thinking from self-defeating musts, shoulds, oughts, and demands. People can be helpful and loving as long as they do not think irrationally. The three areas in which people hold irrational beliefs are in thinking that they must be perfect, that others must be perfect, and that the world must be a perfect place in which to live. The goal of the therapy is to teach people to think and behave in a more personally satisfying way by making them realize they have a choice between self-defeating negative behavior and thought and a more efficient enhancing positive behavior. This is accomplished by teaching people to take responsibility for their own logical thinking and the consequences or behaviors that follow it. Ellis also theorized that a belief system, that is what people tell themselves about an event, determines the responses or feelings towards that event. People naturally and easily think crookedly, express emotions inappropriately, and behave in a self-defeating manner. REBT teaches how to do otherwise. Irrational beliefs cause trouble. Lists of common irrational beliefs that lead to negative emotions and stress in children, adolescents, and parents are included in this chapter. Irrational beliefs can form a chain of further irrational beliefs. The categories of those thoughts are self-defeating beliefs, highly rigid and dogmatic beliefs, antisocial beliefs, unrealistic beliefs, and contradictory beliefs. The first objective of therapy is to show a person how irrational beliefs or attitudes create dysfunctional consequences such as anger, depression, or anxiety. The second objective is to teach the client how to dispute or crumble the irrational beliefs and replace them with rational thoughts. This will allow the client to escape the cycle of negative feelings and be free to choose behaviors that eliminate the problem or the disappointing impact of the problem. A, B, C, D, and E refer to these ideas. A is the activating event, B is the person's reaction to the event, C represents the consequences of feelings resulting from the person's evaluation of the activating event, D represents the disputing arguments that can be used to attack the irrational self-image included in the evaluation of the activating event, and E is the answer given to the questions raised in D. REBT is direct, didactic, confrontational, and verbally active counseling. Several factors help counselors detect irrational thinking. They can look for overgeneralizations, distortions, deletions, absolutes, condemning, and fortune telling. Once the irrational beliefs are recognized, the counselor disputes and challenges them. Ultimately, the goal is for young people to recognize their irrational beliefs, think them through, and relinquish them. To summarize, REBT counselors use exploration, ventilation, interpretation, confrontation, indoctrination, and re-education. Counselors are didactic and frequently assign homework. With children, counselors may find working on internal verbalization and role reversal techniques helpful. Rational emotive behavioral education is an offspring of REBT that focuses on how feelings develop, how to discriminate between valid and invalid assumptions, and how to think rationally. To evaluate REBT, like most cognitive behavioral therapies, has met with a great deal of criticism over the years. Are we at towards the end now? Okay. Let's just start from evaluation, no? Okay. Let's just start from this. Actually, it's part of summary only. I'll not say it as evaluation. Yeah, just remove it off. Rational emotive therapy, like most cognitive behavior therapies, has met with a great deal of criticism over the years. For example, many claim that the discipline as a whole is too rational and that it overlooks the emotions. For founder Albert Ellis, this is an absurd proposition. Ellis holds forth that emotion and thought are interrelated to one another and that one can't divorce one from the other. In other words, by increasing one's rationality, one controls one's emotional problems. I enjoyed telling you the details of the REBT theory. I hope you students too learnt a lot from this particular module. Thank you.